Friends, every Marian devotion has a Christological dimension that leads us closer to Christ. So even in this 11 invocations of the Litany of Loreto, it begins with the cross that we can see behind. So the litany starts from here, and then on the left hand side we have the first litany, which is Kyrie Eleison. So each of the invocation has a Latin name for this. So we shall be seeing each of this, the invocation, and below the picture we have a scriptural quote that is taken from the Bible itself. So we shall be looking now at the first invocation, that is Kyrie Eleison. Kyrie Eleison, O Lord, have mercy. The scriptural quote we find down, the earth is filled with his glory. This is taken from the prophet Habakkuk. Now in this picture, we see the Blessed Sacrament solemnly exposed in a monstrance, adored by a priest, sided by six altar boys. Immediately above is seen Mary holding the infant Jesus in her hand, as if presenting or exposing the incarnate Son of the Heavenly Father to the world. Now the painter seems to convey this message to us. The one who is present in the Eucharist under the species of bread is the same one who was born of the Virgin Mary. He appeared among us in human flesh, given by her. He continues to remain mysteriously present among us in this sacramental yet real presence in the Eucharist. The next invocation, Christe Eleison, that is, Christ have mercy. The scriptural quotation is taken from the books of King. My mother, make your request, for I will not refuse you. Now in this picture we see Christ surrounded by angels. He is seen in glory with his redeeming cross to his right, and he is pointing towards Mary. At Mary's feet are seen the earth on one side, and Saint Dominic and Saint Francis of Assisi with his stigmata on the other side. Now both the saints are interceding for the world before Blessed Virgin Mary, while Mary, looking at them, seems to tell them, "Pray, my son, and your request will be granted, because everything comes from him." Pater de Celi Deus, that is, God the Father of Heaven. This is the third painting, and at the foot of the painting is the quotation from the Old Testament. Tell me, your daughter, who you are. God the Father looks lovingly at Mary, his privileged daughter who is presented in her heavenly glory. Below we see a pope, possibly his Sixtus IV, a Franciscan who was a great devotee of the Virgin Mary. He published a treatise on the Immaculate Conception of Our Lady. He also built many temples dedicated to Mary, and one of them is the Sistine Chapel of the Vatican City. And here we come to the invocation, Fili Redemptor Mundi Deus, that is, God the Son, Redeemer of the world. The scripture quotation is taken from the book of Job. This I know, that my Redeemer lives. In this picture we see Christ, the Redeemer, with his cross. The whole picture calls to our mind the redemption of the world, represented by a spear surrounded by peoples of different colors and races. God the Father is present at the top of the picture, and Mary, the first to be redeemed, is seen under the eyes of the Father. The special place occupied by Mary points to the singular place she occupies in the whole economy of redemption. That is why she exclaims in the name of the whole human race, "This I know, that my Redeemer lives." The fifth invocation, Spiritus Sancti Deus, that is, God the Holy Spirit. The scriptural quotation is the words from the Canticle of Canticles, that of Mary, "By my dove is unique and perfect." The Holy Spirit is consecrated form of a dove and is surrounded by 10 tongues of fire, which is seen moving towards Mary, the most perfect creation of God's loving power. One can also see a friar, seemingly a Franciscan doctor, and one who defended the absolute perfection of Mary, that is, her immaculate conception. Now we come to the sixth invocation of the litany, that is, Sancta Trinitas Unus, that is, Holy Trinity, One God. This is a unique painting that we see here. We see the alphabet A, that is actually Alpha. At the top we see God the Father with his loving gaze that he is seeing downwards. On the right we have the God the Son with the cross that symbolizes the cross, and God the Holy Spirit. All of them, if we see, the Holy Spirit and even Jesus, they look very similar, but the Holy Spirit has a dove on his chest. They all are looking down at Mother Mary, who is, it seems that they are welcoming her into the heavenly glory. Right at the bottom we see the picture, it is of Saint John, because the scriptural title that is down, it is, "These three are one." It is taken from the letter of Saint, first letter of Saint John. So maybe this is Saint John the evangelist who had written the first letter. And we see the angel coming and touching a piece of coal to his mouth so that he can proclaim the mystery of Trinity that we are welcomed into. This is very similar to the call of Isaiah, wherein the angel comes down, touches the charcoal to his lips and cleanses him from his unworthiness. And Isaiah is called to be God's prophet. Now we come to the specially Marian part of the litany, limited only to 5 invocations. The invocation Sancta Maria, that is, Holy Mary, is accompanied by a quotation from the book of Judith. "Blessed be God, who today exalted your name in such a way that men never will cease praising you." As Israel poured praises on Judith for liberating the whole people from the hands of Holofernes, so the people of God never ceases to proclaim the greatness of Mary, who gave the church and mankind its Redeemer. This is the only picture where Mary's image is not to be found. A clear but implicit reference to her is found in the 2 big letters A and M, Ave Maria, beautifully interwoven with flowers. These are the words which was addressed to Mary by the angel Gabriel. In the same picture, we see an angel fulminating Satan, who is thrown miserably into a vessel of burning fire. There are also two cantors who are praising God, proclaiming the glories of the Redeemer and Mary, from whom Son of God took flesh. Sancta Dei Genetrix, that is, Holy Mother of God. We have the quotation from Saint Luke: she gave birth to a son, her firstborn. In a crib we see the infant Jesus surrounded by Mary, Joseph and the shepherds. Mary is again depicted in this very picture, above the crib, holding in her hands her blessed son. The Heavenly Father, a little above the crib, is seen bowing and extending his hands towards the newborn. He seems to say, "This baby is my beloved son. He has no human father." Now the father lovingly looks at the son, and the painter clearly tries to remind us the divine nature of Jesus. Sancta Virgo Virgino, that is, Holy Virgin of Virgins. The quotation is taken from the Song of Songs, that is, the maiden saw her and proclaimed her blessed. Now Mary in this picture is seen in her virginal splendor over a beautiful lily. The lily is a symbol of perfect purity as well as of virginity. At the bottom of the stem of the lily is seen a serpent, which symbolizes Satan. He is beaten by a cross while trying to attack Lily. Maidens of highest conditions, like the queens and princesses of different races, are seen praising Mary, Mater Christi, that is, Mother of Christ. We have here a group picture of the Holy Family, the infant in a manger with Mary and Joseph on each side. The quotation is taken from 2 Maccabees: "I carried you 9 months in my womb and suckled you." Everything in this picture shows that Mary is the privileged mother of Jesus Christ. And with this, we come to the last invocation of the Litany of Loreto: Mater Divinae Gratiae, that is, Mother of Divine Grace. The quotation is taken from Hebrews chapter 4 verse 14. "Let us draw near to the throne of grace." This scriptural text is evidently a Christological one, but the author applies it here to Mary. The painting is not so much visible, but there is a fountain here, and Mary sits atop the fountain. This fountain is the fountain of God, the fountain of divine grace, and Mary is the creature of God who brings the Son of God to this world. Above this we can see a triangle which represents the Trinity. It shows that Mary is full of grace, but her grace comes from above. Friends, we have seen that this corridor is adored with these beautiful paintings, these beautiful frescoes that shows the Litany of Loreto. And just to make you know about the fact, the Litany of Loreto is one of the most approved or most used litanies among the people, and it was approved in the Vatican Council too. As we have seen, that each of this painting brings out a beautiful dimension of our Mother Mary. But all of these dimensions point out to a Christological dimension, that is, to Christ. So Mary is the beloved of God, Mary is the mother of Christ, and Mary is full of grace. But all of these come from above, from Trinity, from Christ, and from God the Father.